Good morning, everybody. Today we are living in the age of aggression. Daily we are seeing newspapers, TVs, aggression, aggression towards doctor, aggression towards people. In that time, management of blunt trauma become very important these days. No financial interest, ocular cause is a major cause of preventable monoocular blindness and visual impairment in the world, especially in the developing countries in young age. And ocular trauma and resultant loss of vision leads to psychological, economical, and professional crippling of the patients. This is the Birmingham eye trauma terminology. Eyewall, scleral or cornea, closed globe injury, no full thickness wound of eyewall, open globe injury, and perforating injury in entrance wound and exit wounds. First, we come to the lead and orbital soft tissue injury. Abrasion may there. Management is normal senile irrigation and cleaning of necrotic debris, prophylactic topical antibiotics, tetanus prophylaxis, documentation, and drawing and photographs for medical legal purpose to these days. There may be hematoma. That should rule out fracture. In case of hematoma, rule out fracture of orbital roof or basal skull. Ice packs for first 24 hours. Indication for incision and drainage of hematoma is if the hematoma becomes infected, tense, and if it is very large. There may be orbital edema. Workup should be rule out occult globe laceration, puncture wounds, and foreign bodies. Examination under topical anesthesia and retractors. Note PLPR, force junction test to confirm non-specific limitation of motility, if any. CT scan to rule out orbital structure or major soft tissue injuries. Treatment is ice pack that diminishes edema and minor surface anesthetics. Oral corticosteroids, lateral canthotomy may be required, orbital decompression. If there is lead laceration, workup should be thorough cleansing and with normal saline, eye saline compressed, tetanus toxoid, systemic antibiotics, preoperative documentation with photographs and drawing for medical legal purposes. And the timing of repair of the lead should be within 24 hours of trauma. Anesthesia should be maybe local anesthesia or general anesthesia in case of extensive trauma, associated bony orbital trauma on cooperative patients and even in children's too. I think this is well taken up by warning. Yeah. Superficial laceration repaired with 6-0 black silk suture removed up. It is removed after 5 days. Lead margin lacerations, trimming of irregular edges, realignment of margin with 6-0 black silk suture along with meibomian gland orifices. Repair of tarsal plates with partial thickness, 6-0 polyglycan vicryl suture. Last line suture with 6-0 black silk. A skin closure with 6-0 black silk with interrupted suture. Suture removal after 7 to 10 days. Laceration with tissue loss. A small defects, lateral canthotomy followed by usual repair. Moderately defect, tangential semicircular flap procedures, large defects, mustard cheeks rotation flap, eyelid shearing procedure, glabellar flap procedures. There may be lead laceration with canalicular injury. I generally use mini Minocca or Crawford intubation set to pass through the punctum. A tubing is then passed through nasolacrimal duct up to the nose, and it is stick to the lateral wall. If there is a conjunctival blunt trauma, there may be subconjunctival hemorrhage, there may be chemosis, subconjunctival hemorrhage, emphysema, rule out globe, in that case, rule out globe rupture or retained foreign bodies, treatment of the cause of the emphysema. If there is conjunctival foreign bodies, irrigation with normal saline, sweeping with cotton tipped applicator, removal with fine forceps, topical antibiotic prophylaxis. There may be corneal blunt trauma. I think it is well taken up by Dr. Sudhir Kumar. There may be acute high drops. In that case, sympathy, empathy, and reassurance. Tell patients corneal rupture will not occur and that vision will improve in 3 months' time. Residual parallel stria, face mouthing, breaks do not impair vision. The main aim is to reassure the patient and parents. There may be corneal foreign bodies. The history of history of the management will be history of circumstances of injury and identification of foreign bodies, multiple superficial irrigation with normal saline, discrete superficial foreign body, a spot or 25 G needle, deep older than 7 days, allowed to remain and spontaneously extrudes if there is no infiltrate, deep large suspected perforation through any through entry size razor blade knife, through limbal suture, intraocular foreign body forceps. Medication should be antibiotic ointment for 3 to 5 days. Cycloplegic eye drops, pressure patching is controversial these days, examination of furnaces and conjunctiva for foreign bodies. These are the 7 rings of blunt trauma to the eye, central iris, peripheral the iridodialysis, anterior ciliary body, maybe angle recession, separation of ciliary body from the sclerosis for cyclodialysis, trabecular meshwork injury, trabecular meshwork tear, zonular tears with possible lens subluxation. This is separation of retina from the orosity, retinal dialysis. Medical treatment consists of atropine, antibiotic and steroids. Iris trauma, I think it is well taken up by Dr. Sudhir Kumar. Yeah, traumatic hyphema. The time of sustained injury is noted, type of injury sustained noted, personal and family history of bleeding disorder is very much to note, drug intake in recent past, any anticoagulant or anything else, history of any addiction, especially alcohol, history of similar episode in recent past. All the patients with traumatic hyphema should be considered ruptured growth suspects, vision, size of hyphema, clotted or fresh blood, intraocular pressure, corneal blood staining, gonioscopy after 1 month post-injury, ultrasonography. Laboratory test should be hemoglobin electrophoresis and liver function test. Supportive treatment should be raised with limited daily activities, metal shield to protect the eyeball, head elevation to 30 degree and control of systemic blood pressure. Medical management would be atropine 1%, eye drops, topical steroids, oral amniocapric acid, 50 milligram per kg every 4 hours for 5 days, timolol maleate, laxative and sleeping pills. Indication for hyphema drainage is if intraocular pressure criteria is that if IOP is more than 50 mm, then for 5 days, and if IOP more than 35 mm for 7 days. Corneal blood staining criteria is that at the earliest sign of blood staining, IOP more than 25 mm for 5 days in total near total hyphema, then in that case we can do hyphema drainage. And duration based criteria is that large clot for more than 10 days, then we can go for hyphema drainage. Surgical techniques for that, paracentesis and tiny chamber washout, surgical procedure of choice, clot expression and limbal delivery, and limbal delivery after four to seven days, automated hyphemectomy. Traumatic glaucoma, it will be taken by my next fellow, Dr. MUAZZAM. Then comes lens, indication for the treatment is dimness of vision, phacoanalytic uveitis, phacoelastic glaucoma. Medical management for you use myotics for a smaller off-axis opacity causing glare, topical steroids to control inflammation, anti-glaucoma medications. Surgical management, if intact posterior capsule, no lens displacement, no vitreous in AC, then anterior limbal approach should be anterior limbal approach. If posterior capsule rupture, dislocated lens, vitreous in AC, then pars plana approach. Anterior chamber IOL is avoided, PCIOL is given by posterior capsule is intact, sulcus fixation lens is the safest in that cases. If there is globe ruptures, things to do be done before starting the urgent repair is establish an intravenous line, start broad spectrum prophylactic IV antibiotics, tetanus toxoid, anti-emetic medication, take sufficient time to obtain cooperation from patient, apply aluminum shield to avoid pressure on the globe, avoid any pressure on ruptured globe, avoid intraocular pressure measurement, avoid ointment of the eye drops. I think this is taken up by Dr. Sudhir Kumar. Traumatic retinopathy, if there is choroidal rupture, vision may return to normal, fovea involved, poor visual prognosis, choroidal neovascularization, laser photocoagulation is a choice. Commotio retini, if it is extra foveal, very good prognosis, foveal may lead to permanent loss of vision. If there is traumatic macular hole, we shall send it to VR surgeons, retinal tear, refer it to VR surgeons. Traumatic endophthalmitis, that will be taken by Dr. Nagendra Prasad. Prevention is better than cure. In a sports, pre-participation evaluation is must, particularly in high myopes, in retinal surgery, intraocular surgery, in any family, if there is any family history of RD. Eye protective device should be used in that cases. My take-home message is, never take blunt trauma to the eye lightly. Patients should always refer to the specialist, like VR surgeons there is, always use protective wear in contact sports, agriculture work, chisel and hammer type of work. Thank you.